From the previous videos, you've already seen that quaternions have some properties similar to complex numbers. And we're going to talk about just a few more properties that quaternions have relative to complex algebra. So first of all, one is the magnitude. Okay, so the magnitude of a quaternion is defined as the square root of the square of each of its components. So Q naught plus QX squared plus QY squared plus QZ squared. Okay, so that's the same way we would define the magnitude of an imaginary number, which only has two components, a real part and an imaginary part. This has a real part and three imaginary parts, so to speak. Okay, and then let's look at the conjugate. Okay, so you're familiar with the conjugate of an imaginary number. Well, the conjugate of a quaternion is very similar. So we're going to call it Q star. That's equal to Q naught minus QX in the I hat direction minus QY in the J hat direction, and minus QZ in the K hat direction. Okay, so you just flip the sign on the three imaginary components, just like you would for imaginary numbers. You leave the sign the same on the real part and flip the sign on the imaginary component. Well, this has three imaginary components. You flip the sign on those three to create the conjugate of the original quaternion. Okay, and it's worth noting that this represents, the conjugate represents the inverse rotation. Okay, so we're going to have a quaternion that defines our orientation, and that includes a rotation from one coordinate system to the other. Well, the inverse of that is just the conjugate of the quaternion. And then another thing that you can work out with the math here that we've already talked about is that if you take a quaternion and do a quaternion product of that quaternion with its conjugate, then what you get out of that is Q naught squared. And I'm not working through this math. You can use the equations that we've looked at in the quaternion product video. Explains how to compute a quaternion product, which anyway, I'm not going to go through that again. But if you work through that, what you get is Q naught squared plus QX squared plus QY squared plus QZ squared. So you get out a real number. So these quaternions had four components. You know, you have the real part and then the three imaginary components. Then you do the product with the conjugate of that same quaternion. It turns out you get a real number out of that. So just a scalar, okay? And it's equal to each of the components squared added together, which another way to express that is the magnitude of the quaternion squared, okay? So that, again, is very similar to complex numbers, where you've learned that if you take a complex number and multiply it by its conjugate, then you get the magnitude squared of that complex number. Well, that's the same with quaternions. So these are a few of the properties that quaternions have that are very similar to complex algebra.